Hey guys, welcome back to Empire, and we're continuing to build Luoyang. Now, in the first part, we started building our city, getting our housing sorted, planting a few farms and all that. We also had to deal with a request from Gancho for lacquerware. We had to import it directly from a trade partner, which wasn't too good. We've started up our silk industry. I know that this looks a bit silly just here, but it's bad harmony. If I get a chance, I mean, I could put it just there or something, just to supplement that bad one and maybe... I don't know, maybe just stuff something of uselessness in that space. And we've also put down a couple of various buildings and all that. We've also started up a mining industry just over here to make weapons. I'm stockpiling the weapons at the moment because we need to make weapons for a request. We're making a load of weapons at the moment. I need to boost my supply of steel as well. Maybe like a one just down here. So I think they don't like trees or something. Yeah, they don't like trees, so we'd have to destroy a lot of these trees to build the thing that I'm looking for. Maybe go that way and then destroy some of these trees just here, and then that'll probably sort it out just fine. So we're making plenty of wood. There's actually more wood than there needs to be in this, but it's okay. It's just the iron ore that they need to get more of, which is a bit farther down than I expected. Now, I'm going to try and get Nuwa into the city because she's going to capture one of these for the... Yeah, because they're going to get killed. That's probably what's interrupting this. So I'm going to try and capture some stuff. Maybe try and sterilize these salamanders over here and sort that out. So we're waiting for our people to come in. We've got three more people ready to come in. Not enough housing yet. So we need to get some appetizing food into the city. We set this to desiring appetizing food. The grand market squares by default always go for delicious food, which we don't need. So I'm going to also start up a bit of a fishing industry because we're going to need fish. So let's do one. Oops, let's just destroy some of the trees. And we're going to put down this just here. And then we're going to have this go right through like that, and I'm going to have, where's the top there? I'm going to roadblock that there, and then have to go in from the side bit just here so that I can be protected a bit. I'll just put down, got a cat in one there, so it has to be just along this bit here, okay. So we're getting that started. We're getting some food in, plenty of food out of these two farms. So much so that I don't think we can keep this supplied. So it's okay. It doesn't look as if we're going to have any issues with spies in this city. We're making plenty of silk at the moment. As far as I can see, we've made 800 silk, which is not too bad. I'm going to give some hemp to Nuwa. She's not pleased. Don't really need to give off the hemp, but it doesn't matter. Oh, there we go. There's the request for... weapons to Nia. We need to get them 8 weapons. We have 5, and they've got given us 6 months to give them some weapons. So that'll start to build up, which will help us. I better turn on some of these, like so. So we're waiting for the appetizing food to come in, which will come in once this harvests, and so does our fishing as well. We're having to go some distance so to get the fish though, so I'll have to boost that a bit. I better start up a clay making industry just over here because we'll need to provide them with access to that stuff. I'm going to have the road going out like this. It means it might not fit perfectly with everything, but it doesn't matter. So, road along here. Excuse me. If we destroy, if we leave some of the trees as they are, that'll be okay. Just clear some of this. Ceramics in there. Where's the ceramics? There we go. And that. And then if we just put down 1, 2 of those, and then 1, 2, 3, and then 4 kilns. So our appetizing food started to come in. These houses will just need access to ceramics and then we'll be fine. So I'm going to put down a ceramic shop just here. So we're building up our supply of weapons here. 700 weapons, we just need to get one more weapon into the thing, which will come from one of these steel weaponsmiths. and then we'll send them off to Nia, and then what we'll do is all the weapons we make from that point on will then go into building up our military, because we need to do just that. So I'm going to put down, obviously, more fishing keys along this bit here, because this is where they're going to have to all go, is along this section here. I hope he can reach all the way along that bit, actually. Let's just draw the road out like that and see how far he can reach. We've got two fishing keys here. It's not really what we need, but who cares. So no supply of ceramic shakes, they're just going to get it made. So that's okay. So I'm going to let this run. I'm going to come back in once we've got this evolved a bit higher, because we certainly need more workers. I might start playing out this other block and start boosting our worker supply quite a bit. But I'll come back to that later. Yep. I'll let these houses kind of stabilise, I'll get them evolved, and I'll come back in if anything interesting happens. Oh, another foreign airship from Nia wants to enter the city. Come on in. Oh, you want to give me 10 jade carvings, how nice. Now, someone, I think, and I've also got Nuwa in the city. Now, I think one of our trading partners buys carved jade. Let's see, who buys carved jade? Let's open trade with us. No, not Kashgar, not Nia. Does none of our cities actually buy carved jade? I would have to try and... What I'll do is I'll just accept the carved jade. And what I'll do is I'll just give it away to cities, and I'll also give it away to the gods as well. Our city now requires ceramics, which is going to start getting made soon, and that'll boost our worker population. I'm also going to have another block of housing just over here. I'm not sure how it's going to go, because it might not reach the distance that I want it to reach. So it might be a bit difficult to provide everything, so it might be a bit cramped. Or it might be in the wrong place, to be honest with you. So where's Nuwa? Come here. You're going to come over here and capture one of these pandas, because that's the nearest thing to us. I'm also going to get you to go capture a salamander, because it's killing off our people. And there's the carved jade. And I also sent off the weapons to Nia, so they're happier with us. They're helpful. So all the weapons I make now is going to go up into these forts. I'm going to start building up my military somewhat. That doesn't need to accept anything. So with the four carved jades that I've got, I am going to give it to someone who buys carved jade. Particularly Yancho, I think, because we'll need them for tea. And I'm going to give paper to Chagan instead. So let's give Yancho 8 jade carvings, because I don't really need the jade in this city right now. So these houses are just about to get access to ceramics, which is just coming in now, which is good. We've got 4 food types in this city. There goes that emissary, which is good. We've made a bit of paper, which is okay. I might end up having this all connected up, and then, you know, I might have it disconnected from the entry point, so I'll just get rid of that bit of road there. And I might connect this up to the remainder of the city, just in case I need it and come back here. What's your rating with us? You're happy. Let's give you 3 silk bolts and I'll get you to Exalted. And those 2 carved jades, I'll just put into like a warehouse and sell it off to Chang'an or something. Maybe even Yancho, because they're going to be needed for tea, which we're going to have to import. Only problem is finding a place for it is going to be a bit difficult. I mean, I might be able to put it just here and have all the tea in port there. Nuwa, go capture a panda for me, please. While I build up my military supplies, we've got a few weapons up here that'll help. Who's the gods again? I think, no, we don't have Sun Tzu. Okay, that's fine. And it looks as if this inspector is able to reach the whole distance of this bit, so I can have all this covered up in all the stuff I need. And if I need to irrigate, then I'll just have to put a thing up the background this bit here, because the exit point's over there, so I can't obviously block that in. Our houses are evolving now, they need access to tea, so there's the panda, that's good. Working our way towards the menagerie goal, which is good. So I'm going to speed this up, obviously start getting this running, and once I've got the trade with Yancho opened up, I'll let you know. Trade with Yancho has opened up, that's good for us. They went straight to agreeable status when I gave them the stuff they want. And you are kidding me, this is a water trade route. No, I didn't really want this. They're a water trade route. I've just kind of wasted a bunch of stuff on them. They're already respectful now from that. But they are apparently going to go out that way and round instead of just taking the easiest option of just taking a land trade route. It looks as if I'm going to have to just import tea to, from Chengdu for now, which seems like a good idea, and I can sell them, so I might have to have them going quite some distance though to get the tea, which is not too good. So, can I actually just place that there? Oh no, that's bad harmony. Okay, fine. I would have to go on that side if I wanted it. Okay. Can we just destroy some of these trees just in here? Can I fit that in there? I can. And that means he's not going to reach the whole distance this time, so never mind. It looks as if I have found a minor bug with Emperor. If we put down the... where is that going? That has to go there. So it looks as if what happens is, see if you place down the forts and don't staff them at all, and the troops all lower their morale for no apparent reason. So I think that's a bug, because I'm pretty sure that's not supposed to happen. I'm going to put down a couple more fishing keys here, but I'm going to drop the length of that road, and if I have to put down more fishing keys, I'll put them on this side instead, where I can maybe have them accessible to this. Right, let's capture that salamander. You are going to import tea. I'm going to have to shift your trading types. We'll sell off the little carved jade that I've got in here. Get rid of that. Booster housing. I'm probably going to have to find another seller of tea. I might have to go with Chengdu and just sell them no goods at all, and then just sell all the silk to other people like Kashgar. In fact, what I'll do is, Kashgar, you're going to buy silk from here, and we're going to set this up to just 4, we don't need to sell tons. Yeah, employees needed. I'm going to import the tea from Chengdu instead. I'm not going to really bother with importing tea from Yancho, and I'll just get rid of this and put it back to how it was, because I don't see how that can work out. So let's put the trading post down for Chengdu and import tea from them. We'll start selling off some stuff to Kashgar that'll help us out completely. I put down another silkworm shed here because we're going to need to boost our silk supply. It looks as if we're getting plenty of workers, which is good. 150 more people ready to come in. This will boost even further when the tea imports start, which will help us in the long run. The salamander's coming along. So we'll sell off the two carved jades that we've got here. Now I'll get rid of this completely. Then I can obviously get rid of this trade post and put this back to how it was. Let's just see. Let's see, is he going to go that way? Yeah, he is, that's okay. So I'll extend the length of the road, and it looks as if this is going to collapse soon if I'm not careful. Let's see, is that going right round? High risk of fire, it's going to catch fire soon. Let's just move that down one. Nia loves us, that's nice. Okay, yeah, 2,000 people who could for us. Let's just speed this up. Oh, there we go, that's sorted. It's because this one's constantly going that way now, so I'm going to get rid of that, and they're going to just go this way. So it looks as if acrobat skills don't catch fire. That's actually quite interesting to note, so good to know that. Houses are evolving, we're getting tea. There's a tea shop in this actually. Let's just put down a tea shop. And yeah, we'll start improving our supply of stuff here. We need more people. We've got 8% unemployment. That's not too good, but it's okay. So we've got two animals. We have. That's good. So I can get rid of Nuwa now, because she's kind of useless. I've got the panda and the salamander. I don't think there's anything else in here. So we'll sell these two pieces of carved jade and then just stop trading with Yancho. We don't need them, it looks like. And as our house has evolved, that's good. I've got plenty of food and tea and all that, so we're just going to import all the tea directly from Chengdu. We're not going to really import anything else from them because they're worthless. Yeah, so all our troops are kind of going in a roundabout route in a fleeing state for some reason. Never mind. Right, so I've sold off the two carved jade. Let's get rid of that trading post. And what I'm going to do is delete this. I'm going to get this to the point where it's just okay, which is there, like so, and then we're going to extend this road a bit along here so that we can put more fishing keys along this bit. That's good. I'm interested to see where these things are going actually. Are they going to any particular point? I don't think they are, but it doesn't matter. So we captured a salamander. These are going to start getting more thingy. I might have to kill them off, which is not such a good thing to do. Plenty of food in stock. I think what I'm going to do is start planning out our area for the elite housing, which is going to go kind of around this space here, close to the rocks, obviously, because we're going to need them. It's a bit of a pain because of where everything's situated. I might have to scout out a section for this. Oh no! Nia is under attack. I can't send troops because I don't have any. These are Tumulus' time, Super Sajuuk. Our most hated rival, Laza, is attacking me. Your ally, Shalwer, at the city of Nia. I need your help to turn back these two-headed dogs. Please send troops within 4 months to help us carry the day. Well, I can't send you the troops. I'm going to postpone that and let you just work that out for yourself, but I cannot send you troops because I don't have the troops to spare at the moment, and I need to build up my military anyway, so this monument is going to have to go somewhere, maybe there. I could actually put the monument here and then have the housing block in this space, because it is close to these rocks that you need for things like inspector's towers. The only problem is it's going to result in a lot of trees being cleared, but I think we can cope with that. So, let's just clear some of the trees, like so, and place down the temple complex. I'm going to... building collapsed. Oh, it can't reach there. That's not too good. Nia wants to give me some paper. How nice. Let's give some of the hemp to Nuwa temporarily. I'm going to set this to accept 24 of that and the rest of it paper. So, this trade post is going to have to get shifted. Let's shift it over to here instead, because that's better connected. We've got quite a lot of unemployment in the city, but we've got plenty of food. We've got restoring far more food as a result of the doubled up food shop. There's a leftover space in case we need to put down a third food shop. I don't really see the purpose of doing that, but we'll see. So as I was doing, just before I got interrupted there, I'm going to put this here. So I'm going to put that there. All the labourer stuff's going to go in this space here. And this big space here will be used for our elite housing. We'll need 6 elite houses to reach the goal. We're not really making any enough silk here. There's the gift of paper. We'll just take that. We're going to set this back up to 32. So that paper will kind of empty itself out into the system. I might sell it, actually, to a city. I need to boost my silk supply here, because we're not really making enough silk off of these farms. I might have to put some irrigation around this, actually. Can we just sort this wall by one tile like so? I'm going to drag the road like this. Like that. I'm going to put down an irrigation pump somewhere. Gap there, which will be for the irrigation, like so. Where's the button? It is here. Irrigation ditch. And we'll just put it around this bit. And then if we just put the pump right there, there we go. One road tile, that's all you need. I'm trying to keep it out of the way of all this, because this is going to get in the way, obviously. Another pause, I might have to kind of do it... I might move these things up a bit, actually, to be honest with you. If we move that up, and if we give away a load of ceramics... where's the ceramics? Let's give them all 12 ceramics. Let's just destroy that, temporarily. I'm going to put that there, and that's going to accept ceramics. So what I'm going to do is destroy that there. And Nia thinks less of me. Why didn't you send troops? My city is now devastated and my troops have suffered horrible losses. I, Shalwen of Nia, do not regard you as highly as before. They have plummeted. They were helpful and now they're down to apathetic, which is actually a lower state than what you might think. So I'm going to put this round here, like so. I'm going to then put this up, like so. And then we're going to do this. So I'm going to have to fit the housing block into this space here, maybe do things around like that, I'm not sure. Can we fit it around? no, I could fit it right in there, but I'd have to sort it out. I'm going to have to give a gift to Nia to stop them getting upset with us. Let's give them 8 baskets of cabbage. That might improve their favour with us. If I don't send troops soon, if I don't send troops to them when the next come around asking for it, they will disappear. But I think I might have to let that happen, because the only thing that they sell is carved jade, which we don't need because we can't make jade anyway, so it's a waste of time importing it. We can make our own paper, we don't need salt. If I need salt, I can import it from somewhere else. Some other city will sell me salt, like Liancho. I could just import it from there if I really need it, which I very much doubt. I can import other food types if I need it. We've got a lot of unemployment in the city, but it's okay. These houses have got everything they need. There's plenty of food, which is okay. So we're getting our irrigation going. So what I'm going to do is plan out this area for the next housing block. I'll come back in once I've done just that. So here's our next housing block here. I hope that this will work. It looks as if I can't get a wall kind of around that bit. I mean, I could just do this. I suppose just kind of make that part of the wall, even though it's kind of useless. I've got an irrigation ditch kind of running around it. It kind of looks a bit weird seeing that, actually. And actually, having that close like that means that some of these farms are actually irrigated, so that helps. Now, you'll probably wonder, how on earth am I going to provide these things with the things they need? This market square could go right through, and that'll help us reach the targets. I'm going to have to obviously import far more tea than what I'm importing. I'm going to have to import it from alternative trade sources as well. Nia's grateful for the cabbage. They've gone up to sympathetic, which is the neutral stance, which helps. They need access to a herbalist. Let's put down herbalist stall, acupuncturist clinic. What am I missing here? I'm missing something. I don't think I am. Am I? No, I've got everything, so I don't actually need anything more. So this could just be filled out with houses as and when they're needed. And there's good feng shui all the way around this bit, so that's good. So these houses will evolve, which will help us in the long run. I haven't even done anything about this, so let's just take stock of the situation and drag some roads out and put down... no, we're not celebrating the New Year, fine. The only problem I find with these is I'm going to have to destroy a lot of trees to get to the rocks in this bit. That is one. Is that out of the way? Nope. I need to get rid of more trees. I don't want to destroy, obviously, tons and tons of trees, because at this rate I'm going to have no trees left. It looks as if I'm going to have to just work with a few of these labourers' camps, because we can't really fit them in. Oh, there's another one just there. That's nice. So the remainder of this space will just be used for things like woodcutters and all those lovely things. They can still get through this bit of trees, because they're not counted as a blocker in this case. Our troops are kind of getting there. We're making far more weapons, that's kind of helping as well. No supply of tea, I'm going to have to import tea from more trading partners at this rate. So who else has tea? We can import tea from Chengdu, right, but we realise that we can't do that. We can't get enough tea out of them. We're not importing tea from Yancho because they're a water trade route. I would have to put maybe a thing up here or something to try and make that work. I'm not sure if I can get the irrigation ditch around this bit. It might not work if I do that. And I need to move that just a couple of tiles, like so. So our house is evolving here, which is good. We're not importing anywhere near the required amount of tea that we need for the city, so... Right, so as I was saying, we've got Chengdu selling us tea, Chang'an sells us tea, and I'm fairly confident they're going to be a land at a water trade route. Which is not going to be too good. I might just have to bite the bullet and just go for it. With the 4 paper that's still left, I'm going to give that 4 paper to Chang'an, because why not? Right, so this needs wood. Where's this going? Let's just do this and block. Let's just do 1, 2. Um, do that. Whatever block is, delete it. I'll put another one of these just up here, I think, and that'll just kind of help the situation. Why are these buttons being so very stubborn to my mouse clicks? It's very interesting that I find that they don't work properly. So we're getting plenty of people in this area now. Now, one thing I need to go and do is actually go and plan out this elite block, because that's what I've said multiple times that I'm going to do, but it never happens. So I'll go and plan out this elite block, and I'll come back in once it's been planned out. So here's our elite block. It's in a bit of an awkward position. The drama school's got to go in that corner because it can't go anywhere else. I'm not going to provide anyone with Buddhism access in this block. I'll only provide them with a Taoist temple and things like that. Who's that just came up? Oh, Chagan, grateful for paper. They're not really improved our rating with us. I need to import lacquerware. Again, I'm going to have to use Chancho for that. Finding additional tea sources is going to be a bit difficult, but I don't think impossible. So we need wood in the city. Let's just put down something for accepting wood here. Let's just roadblock that there, roadblock that there, and then we can just kind of delete that. We'll have two separate sections. So all the wood can go here, and this can accept. I figured the scroll process. There we go. So we'll produce plenty of wood and start kind of boosting the supply a bit, because we're going to need a lot more workers. And we've got plenty of people here, not enough tea getting imported, obviously. So let's import lacquerware from Chancho. And their trading post is going to go way up here because it's just going to have to go up here, I think. How's he got out of there? Oh no, that's the guy going to get that stuff, isn't it? Fail by me. Right, Chancho trading post, you can just go up here. And I'm going to import all the lacquerware from you directly, because I can't make it myself, apparently. No, we're not importing lacquer. Let's just import 4 lacquerware and then send it straight off. Who else sells tea? Chang'an, that's why I'm trying to get them open, because then I can just dump the trading post up here as well. So interestingly, this can apparently get all the way around without any problems, so that's okay. I'm going to put down more housing, because we're going to need it. I'll delete one of the houses shortly, I think. Oh no, that works out okay, so there we go. We'll just have to have some houses that just don't evolve. Oh, bad harmony. Trees, that'll help. Nope, that's not too good. Let's just plant the statues here. Like so. Nope, that's good with the trees. Oh, sugar and bloody strife. The buttons are being very, very weird with me at the moment. There we go, there's plenty of statues, so that'll boost our employment a bit. Looks as if we're not making enough getting enough food into the city, so I'm going to boost the supply of fishing in the city, I think, because we'll need a boost. With a lot more of them. So let's sell off. Get the 4 lacquer we've just imported to Chang'an, the lacquerware, sorry. Alright, one thing we're going to do is do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we've got perfect harmony all around, that's perfect. We're going to put down a tax office. And actually, let's just destroy this and put down the theatre pavilion just there. And we're going to turn off this in a minute when I can get the food shop placed. Ceramics. Turn off this entertainment area, we don't need that, we've got this instead. 3,000 people, that's not too bad. One thing I need to do is start getting animals from other cities, so let's send Nia a panda, because I know they won't have it because it's a desert climate, so we'll send that off. Once we start to evolve our this up, we'll start to boost this, and I just realised we haven't put down a single guild, which is not too good. Carpenter's guilds, they go... they go like that, so let's put them... 1, 2, 3 of them. Actually, that's too many. Let's just put down two of them. I think we'll need one of those, and one of those, and one of those. So there we go. So we're getting lots of job vacancies because we don't have enough housing here, so that'll help. It looks as if we're not getting enough hemp in the city, but I don't think it should be too much of an issue. We're making nowhere near enough silk, so let's put down more weavers here and try and boost the supply a bit and just kind of make it look a lot nicer than it is. I'll just drag that road down. I don't think we'll need any more than this. I think this space here offers more a good place for more farms on fertile ground, because we'll need that, I think. So we've got our food stuff. It looks as if the food is just a bit too far away, and Chargard's grateful for the lack of wear. They are still apathetic for some apparent reason. Do you want another gift of lack of wear? Because I'm pretty sure you'll need this. Come on, take it. Right, so the food source is too far away, so I'm going to have to put down another mill somewhere. I'm not sure how that can be considered too distant, but let's actually destroy this market square. And someone just got killed there by a salamander, it looks like. Yeah, let's just sort this out. Is it too distant if I put the market square like so? And let's just do this. Let's get rid of this. Come on, buttons, work! Why are you so determined not to do as you're told? Goodness sake, right. Food shop. Turn that off. Let's set this to appetizing food only. Hemp. Ceramics. Now, you can't say that that's too distant, because it should be, because it's pretty close. No goods. Great, come on. Let's get this boosted. So we've got some stuff here. We're getting more people into the city, which is good. We need access to an acrobat, and we probably should put down another one somewhere. Yeah, let's just put one just there, and that'll kind of sort that out a bit. Now, what's our gods like? Neglected. Let's give Nuwa a bunch of hemp, because she'll need that. So we're making a lot more silk. I'm going to stop selling silk for a bit, because we're not making nearly enough. That has got no demand. Oh, come on, how can that be too distant? How? Chang'an's grateful for the lacquer, Neo is grateful for the panda. Right, you have respect, we'll open trade with me now. I'm not sure how that could be too distant. Let's just put that there, that road tile. See, does that count as a bit closer? No, it just seems like it's not. We've got workers here. It looks as if they've lost access to music. It looks as if we need to put down another music shop thingy, because I'm going to the wrong place. Where's the thing? Let's put another one there. Kind of boost this up a bit. Let's see. So we've got some houses losing access to acrobat access rather randomly at the moment. That's still too distant. Okay, I'm going to have to find a way of trying to sort the food problem out. I might have to put the mill, a second mill here, and kind of just stick it there or something. Just do this. Oh, we've got a salamander walking onto the monument. That's how that's happening. Let's just stick the mill, a second mill. Buttons, can you stop messing around with me, please? I'm going to just drag that around like that so they don't get messed up. It looks as if I'm going to have no choice but to have that going across that staging area, which isn't too good. We're going to put this except bean card, fish, cabbage and wheat, just like the other one is. So that trade with Chang'an's opened up. Are they water? Again with the water trade routes. Right, I'm going to have to just import tea from water trade routes, because it appears as if we can't actually get the tea. This is a challenging mission in the sense that we're going to have to obviously import a lot of tea from various places that are not land trade routes. So let's just put a bit there. Let's just see. destroy that and put down the actual trade route. No, that's going to be bad feng shui there. Okay. There. For an Erzifrenia wants to give me a Saga Antelope. How nice. Thank you very much. I wasn't expecting that, to be honest with you, but it's very much appreciated. Let's see. Food supply started to build up again, which is good. I'll need to put down one of those. Let's set this to import more tea. Let's import all the tea down here, actually, to be honest with you. I might just get rid of that. And we'll just have this disconnected from the remainder of the city like so. And just have, if we just put down... oh, for God's sake, what is this? Why am I obsessed with feng shui in Emperor? No, we're not doing that. What am I doing? I am completely over the place in this video. Sorry, folks. I might have to just go again. Oh, no, I'm not sending you troops near. I don't have any troops to send you, really. I mean, actually, what I could do is just, if I send you one fort, will that help? I don't think it really will, but I'm not sending all my troops in hope that I don't get invaded, because I don't want that. Let's see. No, not fishing keys. Let's just nerf the map. I can't get this in properly for some reason. Right. I'm violating feng shui. That's it. I'm violating it because I can't get it in properly. So Chengdu sells us tea as well. Let's import all the tea down here. And since we're now violating perfect harmony, I'm going to put this just here as well. We're going to boost the silk supply a bit more. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a warehouse up here. It's also in bad harmony. Which is going to... Actually, no, what I might do is just move the mint. Like so. Can I put the... on that side? No, I can put that there. And I'm gonna move this along. Like so. That's gonna get tea. Like so. Let's see. Let's just boost this a bit. Yeah, so we'll get the people in here, so that'll help. Right, anyway, I'm going to have to leave it for this video because I'm going on a bit longer here than I intended. I've sent off the troops to Nia. Hopefully they'll come back and be happy with us. Our things here are obviously not getting silk because I'm not providing silk, so I'll provide them with silk later in the next video, actually. So, thanks for watching this video. I'm kind of rushing the ending here, so I've gone over my time limit. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video, guys. Bye now.